welcome to another edition of Seamless Style, powered by Politics and Polaroids. I'm your host, Mr. Parker. So, I'm wondering, how did we get this far? 56 episodes in, and we have yet to feature Tweet. I don't know what you guys were thinking. Damn sure don't know what I was thinking. Tweet is my favorite. It's my favorite material in the culture. Hands down. There are things that are a close second. I love suede. I love leather. I love wool, of course. Tweet is made of wool. I mean, the list goes on and on. But Tweet is the top dog for me. That's why fall and winter are my favorite times of year, because that's when tweed is most prominent. What's tweed? We're going to talk about that. We're going to get into it. I'm not going to talk your head off right now, matter of fact. To be honest, as of this recording, I don't even know how many reads we're doing. I know we're doing at least 3, maybe 6. Like, I got a lot of tweed, and I really want to get in depth with it, because there are a lot of different styles of tweed. So I'll get into what I have on, and then we're going to shoot straight into the episode. First and foremost, this beautiful hacking jacket here. It's tweed. It's 100% wool. It's vintage. So it's 100% wool. There's no blend to it. I'll get into that a little later, but some of the newer tweed that's been made over the course of, say, the past 5-10 years or whatever, some of it is a wool blend. It's not 100% wool. It makes it softer, which makes it something that could be worn year-round, because it's a lighter weight, but it's not that vintage tweed look you're looking for. It's not that Scottish, Irish, English tweed look that we all know and love so much. Hacking jacket, window pane. There's a pewter green tint to this jacket. The window pane design is in a subtle red. So it may be hard to see on camera, but I'm telling you, beautiful, beautiful piece. Got the throat latch here, 3-button, dual vented. I paired it with the yearbook panes. I'm going for that cool professor, that cool Ivy League, Duke, Stanford professor, right? So I paired it with the yearbook cords, the yellow ones from year before last. I paired that with a wine wool V-neck with the big giant pea and cream for polo, of course. I did a double RL Club collar dress shirt. The collar on this shirt is a Tattersall pattern, and then the shirt itself is striped. Everything's rather subtle, but when you put it together, especially it brings out this yellow, but it's still muted enough that up top is still about the tweed blazer, the tweed sports coat. And then I also did a bow tie. Because again, I wanted that professor look, but I wanted it to be a little whimsical. So I did the bow tie in the wine navy with the crest. I did the rugby Ralph Lauren patchwork driving cap. And I have on a pair of brown wingtip, a pair of chocolate brown wingtip. So the ensemble it came out exactly how I wanted it. Ralph Lauren yellow foul yard purple. Pocket square, silk pocket square, to finish it off. The ensemble came out exactly how I wanted. Now, it's also everything also fits how I wanted. So this look, the way this look is for me, this is my look. This is perfect for me. I like my jacket snug. I like my sweater to fit. I like my pants slim fit, but not skinny. Man, everything about this ensemble screams Mr. Park. That's why I got it. Right. All right, so look, I'm not going to talk your head off in this intro, man, because we got a lot of rigs. I know, like I said, I got 3 already ready to go, and I think I'm going to end up doing 3. don't know yet, so I don't want to tell you in the intro how many I'm doing. So we just going to keep it moving. Y'all ready? Me too. Let's go.
The Glen Plaid, or Prince of Wales check. Now, Prince of Wales is called that because the Duke of Windsor popularized the pattern, but it's actually a Scottish pattern, right? But Glen Plaid is a woolen fabric and a woven twill design of small and large checks. It's usually muted in color with two light and two dark stripes alternating. Four dark and four light stripes will create that constant pattern of irregular checks. As far as I'm concerned, Glen Plaid is something that if you do collect blazers and suits and sports coats and things of that nature, you have to have at least some Glen Plaid in your arsenal.
So this guy here, we threw on the Polo University tweed Glen Plaid sports coat here. You probably remember that from this particular piece from the Others episode a couple weeks back. We threw that on with this beautiful sweater here by Rugby Ralph Lauren, navy base. It's got that funky chevron style that we see in a lot of those the years pieces episodes, the 1932 blue with the white. All right. So this one is navy with wine stripe here. They get stripes on the sleeve also. Look at that beautiful crest. You got the lion here. You got the Lannister lion. You got three skull and bones in the green. So we have our four basic food group colors for rugby. We have navy, wine, gold, college green. All right. We did a college green and gold all over all over heraldic tie with skull and bone. Okay. Dress shirt in two hues of blue, Columbia blue, Duke blue with white stripes. We did the stretch slim fit chinos in white. Okay. Now, so that the look is polished and that the look is classic ivy, classic prep, we threw on this scarf here. The scarf has a scribbled PRL crest here, polo blue label, navy with wine stripe. We threw it so that it's under the lapels to give it that rushed look, but still a classic man look, you know what I mean? A lot of times when it comes to that ivy and trail look, you're thinking college and university, so you gotta remember everything is not gonna be picture perfect, but that's the beauty of it. It's not supposed to be. Alright? So my man here, he's ready. Like I said, he's one of my best students. I know his dissertation is gonna be right on point. Alright? But yeah, this guy here, this Glen Plaid, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful piece of tweed here. All right, let's go on to another rig.
Herringbone, which is also called broken twill weave, describes the distinctive V-shaped weaving pattern usually found in twill fabric. It is distinguished from a plain chevron by the break at reversal, which makes it resemble a broken zigzag. The pattern is called herringbone because it resembles the skeleton of the herring fish. Herringbone pattern fabrics is usually wool and is one of the most popular cloths used for suits, outerwear, sports coats, blazers. Tweed is most often woven with the herringbone pattern, obviously. Now, all that being said, herringbone is the top dog when it comes to tweed. It's the top pattern. It's the most popular pattern. It's the pattern most people gravitate to. Now, that doesn't mean that other patterns aren't just as popular. It's just herringbone is the king.
This particular gentleman here looks very distinguished, don't you agree? This is one of my colleagues. He's a professor too. He's an English professor. His name's Mr. Lauren. Now, as you can see, Mr. Lauren, he's old English, old world English. He's from Devonshire, actually. He's from Devonshire, England. What he has on today is he has on a pair of Country Wywell Slim Straight corduroys here in the olive. All right. He hooked that up with this beautiful piece here. These pieces here. Now, the vest is Rugby Ralph on. As you can see, the only difference between the two is the buttons, right? The only difference between the two, you have the horn buttons on here. See though, you see that, right? You already know. Got the horn buttons here. You only have one. That's different. That's unique. And these has brown buttons, brown wooden buttons, but it's not these horn wooden buttons here. But the pattern and everything else is the same. The weight is the same. All of the other details are the same. Being that they're obviously from the same Ralph Lauren family, it shouldn't come as a big shock. Waistcoat in the tweed. It's got a subtle herringbone pattern to it. It's very, very subtle. Very subtle. Okay. Same with the Norfolk jacket. Full Norfolk jacket. It is belted in the back. It's got the shoulder splits. And as you saw, the elbow pad, throat latch as well. All right. We did a plaid wool tie, heavy wool tie, and a button down collared shirt is what Mr. Lauren is wearing today. And to finish it off, he's got on a tweed, it's almost a houndstooth pattern. It's very subtle, but it's a different pattern from the jacket and the waistcoat, but it goes together very well. Paired together very well. Same hue and everything. And he has on a pair of brown snuff wingtip boots because he's that guy. He's that guy. I let him talk to you, but I'm a little jealous of his accent, so he's not allowed to say anything to you guys. Anyway. Great look. Oh, and I did, just because the look is English countryside, the look can also be associated with what tweed was originally created for, which is casual outdoor wear for hunting and shooting and things of that nature. I did the hunting horn lapel pin here just to let you know what type of time Mr. Lauren is on, all right?
The houndstooth. So houndstooth is a duotone textile pattern characterized by broken checks or abstract four-pointed shapes, often but not limited to black and white, obviously by looking at this beautiful sports coat here. And in all actuality, the smaller versions of the houndstooth, like on this sports coat, is actually called the puppy tooth, but we're not doing that. Houndstooth, in its history, which started back in the 1880s all the way through the 1930s, it was represented by the rich and the wealthy, and mainly women. It became so popular that, believe it or not, the University of Alabama tried to get a trademark on houndstooth because Paul Bear Bryant wore them on his fedoras. They tripping. You can't monopolize that.
High school here, definitely not one of my best students grade-wise. But he is captain of the rugby team, so like I do with y'all, I keep it all the way 100 with y'all. So I'm gonna be honest. I make sure he passes every time. I played on the rugby team. It's important that our rugby team traditionally is tops in the country. So I mean, I do what I gotta do. So he takes advantage of me, but it's cool. Like I said, he's the top man on the rugby, on our rugby squad this year, last year. All right, but what he's wearing today is a pair of jeans. They have a little distressed here. He has his bag like he actually has something in it. It's Rugby Ralph Lauren messenger bag, leather strap, keyed only entry here. Really nice leather bag. He's wearing a Houndstooth Rugby Ralph Lauren Glen plaid tweed sports coat. Okay, it's single vented, very nice, very comfortable. That rugged tweed, that rugged outdoors tweed. All right, he threw it over his team rugby here, which is also sponsored by Rugby Ralph Lauren. You see the huge crest here with the Griffin. 1934, all types of details here on this embroidered piece, but this is the piece that stands out, that logo. It's color blocked in green and yellow. Got his number there, number 9, which is also on the back, but this beautiful Griffin here with the crown over, that's the piece. That's the piece that everybody, you know, that's the conversation piece of this particular rugby. The rugby collar is yellow stiff instead of white stiff. He's wearing a rep tie with the four basic food group colors. Again, yellow, gold, wine, cottage green. Goes well with the shirt. He has on a knit Oxford button-down sports shirt in Columbia blue and yellow. And then he's rocking a nice little collar thing in here with that collegiate rugby style piece there. So yeah, you know, he definitely can dress. He just refuses to do any work, but I gotta take care of my guy here, because again, like I said, he's the reason for the season. Rugby championships, that's all we looking to take home. It's a really nice bag, man. I might have to take it off, man. All right, let's see what we got next.
Tweeds are an icon of traditional Scottish, Irish, and English clothing, being desirable for informal outerwear due to the material being moisture resistant and durable. Tweeds are made to withstand harsh climates and are commonly worn for outdoor activities such as shooting and hunting. Now what's crazy is that nowadays you get your color effects in the yarn by obtaining the mixed dyes and in the wool before it's even spun. But back in the days, the way they would set in the colors was by using actual urine poured onto the fabric, and then women would sit there and shake it dry. Crazy. Fun fact, but hey, glad they ain't doing that now. So many different types of tweeds, man. Like we talked about earlier, you have the Glen plaids, you have the herringbones, like this beautiful three-piece suit here. Window panes, gamekeeper's tweeds, which was mainly worn by academic types back in the earlier inceptions. Tweed has been notoriously known for being the only material for Norfolk jackets. Plus fours are they're like knickerbockers, but they're 4 inches longer past the knee, and they're more of a pant than a capri style, something they used to wear back in the day. But I mean, if we talking fashion and we talking the history of it, plus fours has to be included, because men and women alike wore plus fours, and they were made of tweed. So yeah, tweed is a very wonderful it's a wonderful fabric that's been around a long time. And look at this suit. I hate to toot my own horn, but look at this suit. This is incredible. Yeah, let's go ahead and get into this suit right.
Bitch, I got no sense. Oh, hit a plug. Ride around with four. Call me Kobe. 24. Can't fuck with her no more. Dollar bitch, she do the most. I get in group on every time I see them folks. I got the underdog. I'm thinking that's something you need to know. I'm smooth and I'm cold. She know my wrist on froze. Skinny jeans on.
Now that I've gotten that out of my system, this guy. I stated earlier that a lot of the more modern tweed that you could purchase is not always necessarily 100% wool. A lot of times it's a wool blend, but you get a different feel from a wool blend in a tweed than you would 100% wool. However, we're talking about the goat here. We're talking about the goat. Not that dude down there in Tampa. Not my guy LeBron James. We're talking about the GOAT here, Ralph Lauren. I bought this suit year before last. It's 100% wool. Has that beautiful tweed feel. It, for lack of a better word, it feels like it's been pissed on and beat dry. As we discussed earlier. Alright? Anyway, three-piece suit, tweed, everything tweed, waistcoat, trousers, suit jacket, herringbone pattern, nice, beautiful, traditional brown herringbone, right? Put all three pieces together. Only thing you don't see here is the pocket watch that I absolutely would wear whenever I wore this, right? Put everything together and then decided, where do we want to have our color? What kind of connections do we want to make here? So I went with the cream window pane wool dress shirt, right? It's a thick wool dress shirt, spread collar, cream with the gray window pane pattern. Tie it all together with this beautiful muffler. Like this is a heavy muffler. It's a long muffler. Something us taller guys can really appreciate, right? Cream and gray complements the shirt. Got the all over rugby skull patterns. Obviously, it's rugby Ralph Lauren, right? We went with which in essence is a houndstooth pattern. You almost just want to call it a solid wool tie in the same hue of brown. Just kind of give it that beautiful English look that we're striving for here. Just to add a little pop of color, we went with the solid red and royal blue with a little bit of Columbia blue pocket square, right? The royal blue, it's almost a navy blue here, is solid, and then the red on it has a small floral print, right? Just to pull everything together. Shoe wise, I'll probably break out something either in a cognac or a dark brown. You could do a medium brown, but it might be a little bit too much of that same hue of brown. So you might want to go a little darker or go with a different hue from the brown family, like a cognac. A light brown shoe would work here also. You could also do a boot in those same hues. You could do a Chelsea boot, you could do a brogue boot. That would work as well because of the cut of these pants and the heaviness of each piece. But this is a gorgeous ensemble, beautiful representation of tweed.
Harris Tweed. What is Harris Tweed? Well, Harris Tweed is a tweed cloth that is hand woven by islanders at their homes in the Outer Hebrides of Scotland, finished in the Outer Hebrides of Scotland, and made from pure virgin wool dyed and spun in the Outer Hebrides of Scotland. This definition, quality standards, and protection of the Harris Tweed name are enshrined in the Harris Tweed Act of 1993. So what that basically means is that the islanders of the Outer Hebrides, they own, run, and have everything to do with Harris Tweed. So, like, you can't get that Harris Tweed stamp from anywhere else but that particular island. That particular item was fully created on that island.
This is going to be our final look. And I wanted to do something that is one of my favorite go-to looks. I'm a big fan of the graphic crew neck sweatshirt with the tweed sports coat or the corduroy sports coat or any kind of heavy sports coat over top with the jeans. That's just a really middle of the road type look. It works for me where I can dress it up with neckwear and the shoes, or I can just kind of dress it down. I could even do sweatpants with that look. I've done it several times. It works. It's just a matter of having the confidence to pull it off, right? But for this look, I broke out the only Ralph Lauren collaboration I've ever liked, which is Ralph Lauren with Harris Tweed. Now, this particular Harris Tweed is also a Donegal and a herringbone combination. It has the herringbone pattern, it has the Donegal Tweed spotted look, and it's on a Harris Tweed. So you're getting the best of every world here. It's single vented in the back. It's got a subtle half yoke, and it's an extremely heavy vintage tweed look. All right, I paired it with a pair of jeans, slim fit, obviously, and I paired it with one of my favorite crew neck sweatshirts here, the RL PC with the collegiate style logo in the middle, V insert to make sure this thing stays in shape forever. It's got a subtle tonal RL here. Washed so that the college green is still rich, but at the same time, it has that worn look that you would really want from a collegiate style crew neck sweatshirt. Threw on a blue and white stripe dress shirt and this particular tie here. Bow tie blue. It has the what we call the Saints logo. I'm gonna put the name of what that actual logo is right here, but as of recording, man, I don't know what it's called. I call it a Saints logo, but it does have a name. I'll look it up and it'll be right there for you. But nice little bow tie complements the overall look of that Ivy Trad collegiate look here, man. Finish this off with a pair of, you could do boat shoes, I wouldn't, but I would do a saddle shoe would work. You could do a driver. I'm not a fan of drivers with this particular style, but you could pull a driver off, maybe something with a horse bit. A brogue, of course, would work. Tassel loafers would work. Penny loafers would be the coup de grace. All right, so that would be the route I would go. A tan or a brown penny loafer is the perfect way to go. It's the Lunar New Year, the year of the ox. So a ox blood tassel loafer or penny loafer. Hey man, you in the house? All right, but this is a look that you can pull off. You can pretty much pull this off every day. You know what I mean? If you need to dress it down, just remove the bow tie. You can remove the bow tie, keep the shirt tucked under the crew neck, or you could pop the shirt up for a more pretentious look if you wanted to do that. I've done it before. It works. But this is a look that you and I in particular can pull off every day. I could go with this every day and feel comfortable and feel like I'm representing.
Really quick, I want to talk about Donegal Tweed. Donegal Tweed is that fabric with the characteristic small pieces of yarn in different colors that you see on inside the herringbone of that gray sports coat. Donegal Tweed comes from the county of Donegal in Ireland. Originally, it was hand spun until they made a loom that was capable of making the Donegal Tweed pattern. It's a beautiful pattern. Definitely something you want to look into.
Smirnoff vodka and Coke. Be careful. Drink responsibly, regardless. When you drink, don't drive, man. Like, seriously, that's just the craziest shit in the world to me. And I know grown-ass men that still do that shit like it's cool. But definitely be cautious when you're drinking this particular drink, because it sneaks up on you. So obviously Coca-Cola, but Smirnoff vodka, and the vodka is vanilla cream. So what happens when you mix it with this Coke, man, this tastes like cream soda or even root beer, which are two of my favorite sodas when I was a heavy soda drinker. So I could sit here and actually down this, but probably about 20 minutes later, Yeah, I'm gonna be feeling it. So I learned my lesson on that. It's a great drink. If you like sweet flavored drinks, this will be perfect for you. Smirnoff vodka, vanilla cream, and Coke, baby. Alright, that's another episode in the books. And man, this was the longest episode we've done for a reason. It's Tweed. Whew. Tweed is just, this was God sent. Tweed was sent down from heaven by the old gods and the new. If you're from Game of Thrones, if you believe in the seven gods, or you believe in the fire god or the drown god, or if you believe in Jesus, Allah, Buddha, whoever you believe in, they sent Tweed to us, man. I'm telling you, because Tweed is the quintessential. It's the quintessential. Real quick, because I changed for you. Slim Fit Chinos, I'm sorry. Slim Fit Chinos in the olive. I did this cream and navy vintage polo sport V-neck sweater vest. All right. And I did the Donegal Tweed Polo Ralph Lauren necktie. I did the chambray shirt. And I pulled all that together with this beautiful tartan tweed. So you have yet another genre or family member of the Tweed family, tartan tweed. Long story short, man. Oh, and I did this hat. We're going to do this hat like we did the logo on the bow tie for the last rig. I'm going to put whatever the technical name of this hat is right here. I call it the Inspector Gadget hat, because I don't know what it's called as of recording. But I threw this on because I just wanted to polish off the look with more English countryside. So I threw this particular cap on. It is Polo Blue Label. It's a subtle houndstooth pattern. Wool, man. Just a beautiful piece, man. A beautiful piece to round everything out. And I'm rocking the brown tassel loafers. Medium brown snuff tassel loafers, just to pull everything together. But this was a wonderful, informative episode, if I do say so myself. Again, we ended up doing five rigs today. Five rigs with informative pieces in between each rig presentation. So it shouldn't be much left for you guys to wonder or speculate about when it comes to Tweed, man. If you don't have Tweed in your arsenal, I'm gonna need you to rectify that faux pas. You gotta have Tweed in your arsenal, man. You got to go get some Tweed. Go get some Tweed now. Just keep in mind, like I said, the past 10 years, a lot of these companies have been doing wool blend in their tweed. There's a difference in feel, maybe not looks, just depending on, you know, how you shop for your tweed, but it's a difference in the feel, and it could be a difference in how long it lasts. I've seen some gentlemen, man, that have pieces from the mid-1970s through Ralph Lauren with the tweed. They're still running strong. So keep that in mind when you're shopping for tweed. I'm gonna venture to say I think only two or three of my tweed pieces total actually came out of a store brand new. Most of them came from secondhand sites, vintage proprietors that only sell vintage apparel. And, you know, we talking 15, 20, 30, 40 year old pieces, man. And they running strong. I don't have any moth damage in any of my clothes, but especially my tweed, where moths tend to, you know, like to procreate and do their thing. Man, all my stuff is in great shape. Every now and then I might have to get a button sewn on. That's about it. So get in the comment section. Tell me what you thought about this episode. tell me what your collection of tweed looks like. Let's just chat it up about the tweed, man. Like, I know I'm not the only one that loves it, so. Because y'all wouldn't be here this long if you did. Right? Right. Hit that like. Hit that subscribe. And tell a friend. We here. And remember, artists, they paint pictures. Haters paint narratives. So don't be no hater. Have a good one.